have Shashank from Third Watch and Parine from Shiplight.
So if we also have Vikas from Shipway.
Yeah, we also have Vikas from Shipway. If you could have the live questions.
Sure. So let me first give this opportunity to Irshad Anwar to talk. Irshad, please unmute yourself and ask your question.
Irshad, please unmute yourself.
Yes, yes. You are hearing me?
Yeah, very much.
Hello. Yeah, 1 second. I will put on the camera.
Hello.
Yeah, yeah, we can hear you.
Yes, sir. Hello, sir. We have onboarded to Myntra last year during October 2019, sir.
Yeah.
Which still we couldn't able to sell our products. Our listings are still not live. Only photo shoot has been completed by Myntra shoot service, and still it is pending.
So Irshad,
we have to get the access of Unicommerce to link our stock and sell the products.
Sure. So thanks a lot, Irshad. Two things. The first part is related to Myntra. So unfortunately, the networking hour for Myntra and Marketplace for the first half. And so now we do not have got any representative from Myntra, but surely we have a very deep connect with them. And it's a deep relationship with them. We'll definitely take it forward. We'll ask them to connect. Would be great if you can share your email ID and your phone number over the chat, or you can write us to contactus@unicommerce.com. We'll help you connect it. We'll help you get this questions resolved. Once you are writing it to us, surely our team will get back to you in both the aspects. We'll help you how to sign up with Unicommerce and get it onboarded on Myntra. Hope that is the answer of the question.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, sir. Your email ID, please. Shall we get?
Anubhav, can you please help over the chat room? So it is contactus@unicommerce.com.
Contactus@unicommerce.com. Okay.
So next, I am giving this opportunity to Thea Garajan. So sorry if I am unable to pronounce it well. Thyagarajan, can you unmute yourself and then talk? For audience, let me also tell you, we have got Anshuk from we have got Shubham from AdYogi as the panelist, and he'll take all the questions on behalf of Anshuk. So we are welcoming the questions for AdYogi. We are welcoming the questions for Third Watch, Shipway, and Shiplight. Okay. Next, move towards Ben. So Ben, talking rights have been given to you. Please feel free to question.
Hello. This is probably for Adi at AdYogi. I'm just planning to probably start a drop shipping with Shopify or any other service provider. So how do I start, and how Adi and AdYogi can help me on this? What would be your advice?
Thank you, Ben, for the question. So my advice for drop shipping would be that you can definitely start by marketing on Facebook and Instagram. So after, you can build build a website on Shopify for drop shipping. Once you build that, you can obviously use Facebook, Instagram primarily to get your first 100 orders on your dropshipping website. Now, how you can get on Facebook is obviously by running ads, which are primarily conversion ads that you can run. And along with conversion ads, you can run remarketing ads as well to get orders on your website. So if you ask me, my first suggestion would be to get a Shopify website up. And post that, you can definitely start by marketing on Facebook, because it's generally very easy to get sales, at least for first 100 orders. It's very easy to get sales on from Facebook and Instagram.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks. So thank you, Ben, for asking the wonderful question. So let me just quickly give this talking right to Devendra Singh. Devendra, please unmute yourself and go ahead and ask the question. Devendra, you need to unmute and then talk.
Hello.
Yeah, please go ahead.
सर मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि जैसे कि अपने को ऑनलाइन में कौन सी कैटेगरी अच्छी रहती है सर, खुद की अगर वेबसाइट बनाए तो अपन किस कैटेगरी में प्रिपेयर करें तो बेस्ट रिजल्ट मिलता है राइट नाउ? हेलो
यस सो अगेन दैट डिपेंड्स इफ यू टॉकिंग टर्म्स ऑफ वेबसाइट डिजाइनिंग तो आई वुड सजेस्ट टुमारो सेशन विल बी ऑफ ग्रेट हेल्प टू यू बिकॉज़ वी हैव गॉट प्लेयर्स हु आर will be really helpful in terms of website designing and the other context to it. But okay. Shubham can answer this or maybe Shubham can pick it up, nothing like it.
Okay. Sure,
Mubashir. Devendra, ek baar aap fir se bata sakte hain ki aapka exact question kya hai?
So Devendra ka question tha ki kaun si category achhi hai jo aap online sell kar sakte hain aur uski website banate hain to fayda hota hai.
All right. So Devendra, हमने जो देखा है हमारे एक्सपीरियंस में ऑनलाइन में अपैरल इज समथिंग जो बहुत चलता है बिकॉज इट इज समथिंग जिसका डिमांड कभी कम नहीं होता है एंड पीपल आर विलिंग टू परचेज ऑनलाइन. Similarly, if you go for, you can also go for footwear or jewelry as well. So artificial jewelry also sells really well along with footwear as well.
Thanks a lot, Shubham. So next, I am giving it to Dilip Behra. Dilip Behra.
Sir, good evening. This is Dilip Behra. I just started my website in 15th of August. It's under Shopify platform. So first of all, thing we have placed so many products, mixed use products, and a lot of apparel, jewelry, and all other things. So I need to find who can help me to get more products onto it, and first 100 sell, who is going to help me? Now we are ready to sell our products on the site. So this question will go to whom, sir? Who can guide the first 100 sales? We are already started promotion and everything.
So under sales, I guess Shubham is again, because when it is coming down to promotion and marketing and So Adyogi is the right contact. But in addition to this, we'll be having one more session tomorrow in which you'll be having again a couple of service providers who will be able to help you in this. Would request you to, join the session tomorrow as well. If Shubham can pick this up, nothing like it. Too many questions for you, Shubham.
Not a problem. Always a pleasure to answer questions. So Dilip, to get first 100 orders, as I just mentioned, for new e-commerce websites, Facebook and Instagram are the best platforms where you can begin marketing with. Now you can go ahead with starting with your own Facebook campaigns on your ad account. And I would suggest that you start with some kind of a conversion campaigns because conversion campaigns generally help in getting sales on your website. Alternatively, you can also start with remarketing. So once you, for example, get new audience onto the website through conversion campaigns, you can then remarket them. So anybody who's dropping out on the, say, a product page, add to cart page, or a checkout page, you can remarket them and bring back them on the website for final purchases. If you're looking for some options, we do have a Shopify app as well. You can search it by the name of Facebook Ads on Shopify. I can connect you later on and help you with that as well.
Sir, if you can help me, I think it will be really great. I'll put my details on chat box.
Sure. Thank you.
So next in line, we have got Anil. Anil, please go and ask your question. Anil, we have given you the talking rights. Please unmute yourself. And I guess your question is with Third Watch. So Shashank, please be ready for it. Anil, you need to unmute yourself. You are speaking, but you need to unmute. So anyways, I'll read out the question for Anil, what he have mentioned. Anil, question is, does the system detect incomplete address specifically? And if yes, then does it give the mechanism to complete it automatically?
Thanks, Anil, for the question. So, Anil, yes, system detects the incomplete address, whether this address is deliverable or not. And it raises the reason also on the dashboard, that this address looks incomplete. Yeah. Address recommendation we are working on. It's not easy problem, but in the near future you will see that in the server dashboard where we suggest the complete address. But for now, like, there are some automation mechanism. You can send the confirmation link to the customer, and you can call them, or you can send them SMS and ask for correct address or nearest landmark.
Thank you, Shashank. Next question is coming from Saravanan Aliappan.
Yeah.
So, Saravanan, have given you the talking rights. Please go ahead and ask your question. I guess your question is with Chipway, right?
Yeah. So, good evening, all. It was a wonderful session. So, just I want planning as a startup. So, in this, I am planning for a e-commerce for FMCG products. So, which would be the best way for a delivery in shipping part, whether it is to opt for a dropship or a dropship, omnichannel.
So I guess this question can be answered by both.
Yeah.
Right. So thanks for your question. So you can go with your omni-channel or your dropship. Because in dropship, you have delivery delays are a lot big challenge in dropshipping model. So in that case, you need to go with your own courier. This is my suggestion. But there are lots of plus and minus in both of the cases. So for more details, you can contact us.
Thank you. Parinay, would you like to pick this up?
Avashir, I agree with what Vikas said. Dropshipping is a lot dependent on the vendor that you onboard for actual the product. So if the vendor management is not streamlined, your customer experience is hampered.
Right.
So I'm giving an opportunity to Vamsi. Vamsi, can you please ask your question?
Yeah, it was a very nice session. I just want to ask, we deal with iron and steel business. So we are trying to get online since long time, but we are having difficulty. We weigh a lot, it's in 1 ton and 2 tons of weight. So does any delivery system help us for this large amount of weights which we can deliver? And if so, how much do you charge for such shipments?
Parinay, would you pick it up?
Right. Vamsi, so I also mentioned this in the presentation. People think that aggregation is only for e-commerce business, but we are also providing B2B carriers on the platform. What I'll do is I'll leave out my email on the chat or on the Q&A, and we can connect offline and discuss about the commercials. We do have part truckload shipping services.
Superb. So now I'm giving talking rights to Geeta. Geeta, could you please take your question?
Hi. I don't know how much is relevant to this session. My question is that I deal with A2 milk and milk products, and that is a perishable item. It's a raw A2 milk. So how can I, first of all, promote my more sales? And secondly, about the delivery, can any of whoever is available, they deliver my products? It will be early in the morning, 5 o'clock. It's possible. Swiggy has done this. Swiggy, apart from giving deliveries of food products, they even deliver milk products, even though it's perishable. So can anyone just answer my sales and delivery thing?
So I'm just throwing it open to the panel. If somebody would like to pick it up, please.
I think I'll just help Geeta with that. So Geeta, for the milk run model, typically we've seen companies having their own bikers and own resources, or if not hiring, if hiring them is not suitable, then you can probably work with a company like Shadowfax or Lala Move if they are available in the target city that you want to. And they do have dedicated biker models for you, wherein they will also do the route mapping and planning and deliver the perishable products. So any typical courier will not take up this service.
But adding to that, you can also speak with Dunzo.
Dunzo can also do hyperlocal.
Right.
So I am giving this opportunity to Rama Samay Chandrasekharan. Please unmute yourself and speak. Or Rama Saran, you are already live. Please ask your question. Okay. So now moving towards Brijraj. Brijraj, we have given you our talking rights. Please ask your question. Bridja, you are speaking, but you need to unmute yourself. In between, let me just take up a question from Thyagraj. Thyagraj. Okay. Moving towards Srikant Chandak. I'm giving you right. Please ask your question.
Hello.
Yes, Srikant, you are audible.
Yeah, my question is to add UD. Like, we are into apparel business and we are doing a GMV of about 5 crore monthly. So, on market basis. So, I need to understand, do we need to start the D2C platform for a gooder expansion or we should focus on marketplace?
Sure. Thank you for that question. I think that's a very good question, Srikant. So there's a difference between marketplaces and your own D2C website. So the primary difference between these two is that in a D2C website, you actually own the customer data that you get, right? So for example, when you are starting a D2C website, you will have to spend some money on acquiring the customer, right? So once you have spent that money, you practically own the customer in terms of you can get repeat purchases from them and you do not have to pay anything. So once the customer purchases the product from you, he or she likes the product and he would want to purchase again without any an additional cost with you. Whereas in case of a marketplace, you always have to pay some amount as a commission to the marketplace, be it Amazon or any other marketplaces. So that is one of the primary reasons. All along with that, you can obviously retarget your existing customers again and again in a D2C website, right? So through emails, through through Facebook ads, through Instagram ads, or through SMS retargeting, you can continuously retarget your customers whenever, say, for example, you are launching a new collection for spring, summer, autumn, winter, or you are doing any kind of end of season sale or something of that sort, right? So the control over your buyers is something that is really there in a D2C website. So both D2C websites and marketplaces have its own perks, pros and cons. Typically what we have seen in case of big brands also that we are working with, they obviously started with marketplaces, but now as high as say 20% of their sales for a lot of the brands account from their D2C website. It has its own pros and cons when it comes to marketplaces and D2C websites.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So now let me quickly announce the winners. So Parul is the winner. Parul is the first winner. And second winner is Ragit Agarwal. So again, I repeat, Parul is the first winner for the day. Second winner is Ragit Agarwal. And third winner is Saravna. Third winner is Saravna. So we have got three winners. I would humbly request all our speakers right now from AdYogi, Shipway, and Shiplight, and Third Watch to share the best question nomination so that we can announce the winners before we end up this session. We have got few more questions to take. I would also request the audience to please do share the feedback of this today's event, that will be really helpful in improvising the quality, the content, the duration and everything. And that's how we are going to give you we are going to deliver a better quality content, and next event we will be implementing all those changes. And we'll try to improvise the format for you also. So would also be requesting you all to please share the feedback in terms of poll. So we are launching a poll right now, and then we'll be moving towards a question. And I'll give the opportunity to Lavanya to ask her question. So the poll is live. Please vote. Lavanya.
Hello. Yeah, hi. This is Tushang. This is
Hello, Lavanya.
Hello.
Yeah,
I'm audible. So basically, this is Tushar. This is Lavanya's brother. So this is our account. So I was watching this session through our account. So I hope it's not a problem. So basically, my questions arise that I am currently working on different marketplaces. I'm working from 4.5 years now. Now I have planned to launch a multi-brand sneaker boutique in US, North America region. Basically, I'm currently working with some marketplaces for any region. Okay. So my question here goes with to AdYogi that I'm planning to work with Shopify for my own portal. So is it possible to have an ACoS of 20% in initial time? Is it possible?
Sorry, Lavanya, Tushar, your voice was breaking. Can you repeat the question?
So my question here is that I want to start a multi-brand boutique of sneakers. So I would be going for the NA region. So currently I'm also working with the NA region, North America region. Okay. So I am preferring to go through on my own this web store through Shopify. So my question goes to AdYogi that is it possible to initially launch with my 20% of ACoS for the web store? Because my back costing, I have calculated and done some costing. So is it possible to get a sale having a spend of 20% on the generated sale revenue?
So Tushar, it depends actually from industry to industry and your average order value, to be very honest, when it comes to figuring out what will be your cost per sale on a D2C.
ASP is coming like $100 to $120. Okay.
Sorry, how much?
$100 to $120.
$100 to $120. And this you want to market in US, right? North America?
Americas, yeah. Total Americas. Yeah.
Got it. So Tushar, what we have seen when we have marketed for brands in the North American region, it's comparatively expensive than marketing it in India. Primary reason being that the CPM in North American region is 5 times more than CPM in India. So
okay.
Just to give you an example, an average cost per 1,000 impressions in India hovers around say 150 rupees. So in US, to show your ad to at least say 1,000 people or so have 1,000 impressions, it will be costing 5 times of 150 here, right? So comparatively, what we have seen when it comes to defining what will be the CPS, yes, it hovers around say 20 to 30% of your average order value.
Yeah.
Having said that, it's more on the basis that once we start running an ad and once we actually get the matrix after the end of first month. So it actually depends on what is the CTR that you are getting, what is the landing page views per link clicks that you are getting, what is the cart rate that we are able to get, what is the transaction rate that we are able to get. That is where we are actually able to figure out what will be the cost per sale that is generally going to be for the brand.
I also have around like 20 to 25,000 data of users who have already done purchases from me from past years. So,
and that is from India or US?
So, just to add up here, would be great if you can attend tomorrow's session that is more inclined towards the cross-border trade and couple of partners. Service partners and marketplaces will be really help you in figuring out all your
basically my operation part is done. Okay, operation part is done. I have directly worked upon with DHL and they are good, offering me a very pretty good rate for the D2C model. Only thing is here is with the good marketing partner. So I even added Shubham on my LinkedIn, but I couldn't have time to connect with him. Great. Shubham, is it possible to connect with you?
Sure. I'll just drop my email ID on the chat. You can just drop me an email and I'll connect you tomorrow itself.
For the strategic partner development for AdYogi.
Perfect. I'll just drop you an email on the... I'll drop my email in the chat box.
Drop me your email address. I will connect with you. Okay.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you a lot.
So I'm giving the next ride to Raju. Raju, unmute yourself and please ask your question. Raju, you are saying something, but your microphone is on mute. Okay, so let me quickly move on to Ravi OR. Ravi OR, I'm giving you an option. Please go ahead.
Yeah. I want to ask for the agrochemical products that are in rural India to farmer level, is it possible to sell online? One is B2B and B2C. B2B refer to retailers, like appointing e-retailers, and B2C is directly to the farmers.
Open to all the panel members. Somebody would like to pick it up, please. Ravi, can you repeat your question, please?
I'm asking, is online will be the best option to go for selling agro input products like pesticide seeds to the farmer level in rural India?
Okay. So I guess, again, this is a question for AdYogi. Shubham, would you like to pick it up?
Yeah. So, Ravi, in case of, say, farmers and all, what really is required is that, so, you know, when it comes to selling online, we eventually have to get people on the website. So, and what I'm assuming is that to sell pesticides to, say, farmers and all, it would be difficult for them to, get them onto Facebook and then direct them towards your website.
Some problem with your mic.
How about we can't hear?
Am I audible now?
Yeah, now it's fine. Fine, Shubham. Yeah.
Yeah. So, Ravi, what I'm saying is that considering that your target customers are farmers, right? Uh-huh. It would be kind of difficult to be very honest, selling them through, say, Facebook ads or Instagram ads, because primarily what I'm assuming is that it would be very difficult to target them and from Facebook and get them on your website. What I would suggest is that if you could just look for a online marketplace to begin with, that would be a much better option when it comes to, say, selling to farmers online.
What about e-retailers? Means appointing the retailers and B2B, B2B to them.
B2B would be a better option rather than direct D2C. So I think if you can, B2B online definitely works. So you can definitely have a B2B website where you actually kind of target e-retailers who will buy your products in bulk or in retail and then sell it to farmers further. So B2B website can definitely work when it comes to online D2C websites.
Second question is, we are already doing a lot of business in offline. We have a good network of distributors, retailers, but India is a very big country. We can't cover all the zones. So seeing something as an online option means how we can coexist offline as well as online. So there's no conflict. Is there any way?
So maybe omnichannel can be a one thing which you can pick it up. Maybe to start off, we can identify with the most progressive states, identifying the geographies where whereby it's all about, you know, analyzing few data points and accordingly you can take a call. So few data points whereby people are very much too keen to buy those, you know, products similar on those lines, from specifically coming in from metro cities and maybe nearing metro cities. So that is two categories or maybe two geographies which you can target initially, and you can launch simultaneously or can opt for the both the ways in that particular geography to have a presence online, and then you can have a store offline. So that can be a good marketing start. And once you are getting some good starter from there, then you can identify new geographies coming in, and then you can pitch in your products there. So that can be a good play to begin with.
This one more is about for Shiplight or anyone, Shiprocket. Yeah. So it means you told already this is not only for the online people, you also give support for logistic support for offline business. Means when it comes to rural India, means where the penetration is village level, means for offline also you give that level of services, and it will be a cost effective, because when it is a 20 kg drum, 5 liter bottles, and means will it your services will be cost effective to take it compared to currently how C&F will be having, and he is having his local transporter arrangement to deliver it to the last mile.
Varuna, this is a question for you.
I started speaking, but I realized it was on mute. Yeah, so Ravi, I wouldn't say that. So price, honestly, courier prices, so shipping is not a problem. So when we say 20 liter drum or a 5 liter fertilizer, we can ship them to maximum pin codes in the country. But I am not really sure we can comment on the price competitiveness when compared to offline or traditional transportation modes. So when we talk about between carriers, they're competitive. But comparing to, you know, the traditional transporters, it's a little, the price differences are there, being very honest.
Okay.
So you might have to, you know, work around the cost if you're willing to sell online, you know, or possibly have a small part of the shipping fee being charged from the buyer. You know, typically because these products are being bought in bulk. So, you know, have a higher price online probably, or have a small part of shipping fee, so it covers some part of your shipping cost.
Now, coming to liquid, most of the courier rejects to take the liquid when it comes to online.
Right.
Services, is there anybody who provides, carry the liquid, even if it is small, means when it not be very big, high value item with a small, so which can cover the shipping cost, even if it is costly.
So liquid can be shipped to surface, Ravi, but it depends what kind of liquid are you talking about. If it's an actual prohibited hazardous liquid, then I'm afraid shipping is not possible.
No, it is like about fertilizer, liquid fertilizers, or pesticides, liquid pesticides, or hormones, which is for fish hormones and aquaculture. So those types of products.
Then absolutely, Ravi, liquid is possible for sure. Liquid shipping is possible. We've been shipping fertilizer, sanitizer during the last 3 and 4 months, 5 liter, 20 liter packaging of sanitizers, and definitely then we can also ship liquid fertilizers.
Okay. Is there a courier who takes that, or you supply it, or?
No. So we do not have any physical presence. The courier would only pick it up. So what we can do, Ravi, is we can connect offline. We can understand the nature of the product. And then, you know, have this discussion in detail.
Okay.
I will just drop you my email address directly.
So, you have been a great and lovely audience. It was just that few people were raising hands and I guess they were not able to speak, or maybe they exited. Or maybe there's some issue with some tech piece. So, that's the reason I have just put down the hands down. Would again request you, if you have got some live questions, please give your hands. We have got another 5, 10, 15 minutes to go. And then we are going to take your live questions and we'll love them answer. So it's just to avoid the confusion, we have, you know, raise your hands down. So again, if you have got some questions, please raise it up. So now I'm giving right to Galaxy A70s. Because name is not mentioned, please unmute yourself. I've sent you a ping to unmute yourself. Please unmute it. So please unmute yourself. Anyways, so next I'm allowing Rahul Bhatnagar to ask his question.
Hello.
Yes, Rahul, we can hear you.
Yeah, I'm Rahul Bhatnagar here. So my question is to Ad Group Analyst. Hello.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. So my question is to Ad Group Analyst. I basically am a small entrepreneur in bamboo products and bamboo handicrafts selling online.
Rahul, sorry to correct you. It is Ad Yogi.
Yeah, sorry, sir. My apologies for it. I'm basically a small entrepreneur. Past 3 years, I'm be selling online bamboo products and bamboo related handicrafts. My question was, sir, what is the best content that works out for such products? Because I have a allied agency with me who is working with me. They have been suggesting me to go in for more and more video-based products. But looking at their budgets and the constraints that we come across, that content doesn't seem viable. So my question was, for small entrepreneurs like us dealing in such products, what would be the best content to play online?
Sure. Thank you for the question, Rahul. So when it comes to handicraft products, right? So what I generally would suggest you is to first test it out. What kind of ads is working best for you, right? So there are, say, for example, 4 types of ads that primarily run on Facebook, which is carousel, slideshow, single image ad, and single video ad, right? So you can start by first A/B testing what kind of ads and creatives work really well for you when it comes to paid marketing. Once you've spent some money, some budgets on all these 4 types of ads, you'll obviously see that some of the types of ads are getting more attraction and getting more engagement as compared to others, right? I am not sure what kind of ads you were running in the past, but typical practice.
Basically, carousel. We are only currently focusing on carousels, nothing beyond that, because that's what our budget constraints are.
Okay.
But the agency has been suggesting us to go in for more viable solutions.
All right. So, Rahul, another suggestion when you're talking about videos is that there are a lot of video creators online as well. You can try some of those video creators. These are typically are not that high priced. They do have some very good templates where you can just put your handicraft products and mention some of the USPs of the product and create a very attractive video out of it. What we have seen is these kind of videos have worked really well and give a very high percentage of CTR and engagement on Facebook and Instagram. So you can try video. If carousel has not been working well, I would suggest to go with slideshow as well. Slideshow is again a type of video ad where you can market multiple products and see what the response is. So what I would suggest is if carousel has not worked, you can try the other 3 types of ad formats that's available on Facebook and then see what works best for you and go ahead with that.
Okay. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you.
So next, I'm giving a right to Anurag Madan.
Hello. I'm audible?
Yes.
Yeah. Hi, Kapil. Once again, Kapil and Team Unicommerce for such an insightful event. Okay. My question is for Ad Yogi Shubham. Hi, Shubham.
Hi, Anurag.
Hi. Actually, my question is that, basically we are a, startup for the women's ethnic wear from Mumbai. So we are having a portal. We have just started off, via Shopify platform itself only. Mm-hmm. Coming back, say, I think say 15 of day or 1 month back. So my question is that for us being a startup, and for a category like us, women wear, as startups are having the, very, limited budget. So we are a non-funded home-based startup. Mm-hmm. So for us, what is the suggestion you provide? Would it be a engagement campaign we can go directly, or we can, wherein we can build the customer and then later on, in the long term, it might help to build the, customer and get the benefit of the non-paid marketing in the long term? Or directly we should start off with the conversion campaign, which would, maybe it can be, pretty little expensive compared to the engagement campaign. And then, or we should parallelly run the campaign and engagement campaign and the engagement campaign, parallel engagement campaign and the conversion campaign parallelly. So, and within the limited budget, because we had a very limited budget, as being a startup. So that is my question. If you can address, that's what, yeah.
Sure, Anurag. Great question, first of all. So even for a startup, what we generally prefer or we generally suggest is to go for a conversion campaigns and not an engagement campaign. So for example, a traffic or a brand awareness campaign, I think Anshuk also mentioned this in his presentation that, what we have seen is brands spending lakh rupees on just getting traffic or brand awareness on their website, but it has not resulted in any sales for them. And to be very honest, for any startup in e-commerce, sales is what matters the most at the end of the day. So I would preferably suggest you to go for a conversion campaign and try to get first 100 sales on your website. Now, what happens is that when you are running an engagement conversion campaign, initially the cost of acquisition or cost per sale would be high. But after you have done, you got your first 100 sales, Facebook actually recognizes the type of audience that is clicking onto your ads and coming onto your website. Your campaigns go from learning phase to active phase. So Facebook actually realizes which type of audience are the best suited to buy your product. Now, from going from 100 to 1000 sales becomes much easier because Facebook optimizes the campaign. You actually will figure out what kind of audience is coming onto the website, what are the metrics when it comes to add to cart, transaction rate, CTR, landing page views per link clicks, right? So I would suggest that to go for conversion campaigns as compared to engagement campaigns. Once conversions are happening, engagement starts happening on its own. People will receive your product. If they like the product, they will engage more with the brand and with more with your ads and your Instagram and Facebook pages as well. So primarily, I would suggest to go for conversions as compared to an engagement campaign.
Thank you, Anshul. Thanks a lot. So let me again give this talking opportunity to Parul. Parul, your question, please.
Hello, am I audible?
Yeah, go ahead.
हेलो माय क्वेश्चन इज रिगार्डिंग एडवर्टाइजिंग अभी जैसे अपना पर्सनल वेबसाइट होता है ना हमारे प्रोडक्ट जैसे शर्ट से लिनन एक्सक्लूसिव और पर्टिकुलर कस्टमर किसी और वेबसाइट से समझो कॉटन शर्ट्स परचेस कर रहा है देन वो टाइम पे उनको हमारी एड दिखाई दे उसी रेंज में बेस्ट प्राइस में अपनी लिनन शर्ट एक्सक्लूसिव समथिंग लाइक दैट ऐसा कोई एडवर्टाइजिंग कैंपेन होता है क्या
हाय पारुल आप एक बार फिर से क्वेश्चन बोलेंगे आपको क्वेश्चन क्या था
नहीं क्वेश्चन ये है अभी देखिए जैसे अपना प्रोडक्ट है मेंस शर्ट्स एंड एथनिक्स ओके अभी समझो कोई कस्टमर है ना किसी वेबसाइट पे जाके कोई शर्ट की वेबसाइट है समझो zodiacshirt.com समथिंग है तो वो वेबसाइट पे प्रोडक्ट ब्राउज कर रहा है सर्च कर रहा है परचेस करने के लिए तो वो टाइम पे उसे हमने अपना जो शर्ट के लिए प्रोडक्ट एड क्रिएट किया हो और वो टाइम पे उसे वो एड वो वेबसाइट पे दिखाई दे रेकमेंडेशन के तरीके जैसे हम यूट्यूब पे सर्च करते हैं तो रेकमेंडेशन हमें आते हैं एज पर योर इंटरेस्ट ओके तो वो दूसरों की वेबसाइट पे अपना एड कैसे विजिबल हो जो हमने लगाया है अपने प्रोडक्ट के लिए तो ऐसे कोई एड स्ट्रेटेजी है
पारुल ऐसा हो सकता कि वेबसाइट पे आप अपना प्रोडक्ट मार्केट कर सको बिकॉज़ साइट में जो एडवर्टाइजिंग स्पेस होता है डिपेंड्स ऑन ईच वेबसाइट की उनको इसको लेवरेज आउट करना है कि नहीं होता है फॉर एग्जाम्पल जोडियक का कोई शर्ट बाय कर रहा है तो आप उन्हीं टाइप के लोगों को जरूर टारगेट कर सकते हो फेसबुक और इंस्टाग्राम में तो जैसे आप कह रहे हो जैसे जोडियक हो गया या फिर कोई और टाइप की शर्ट ब्रांड कंपनी हो गई जैसे बॉम्बे शर्ट हो गया या कोई और ब्रांड हो गया
राइट जो लोगों को इन ब्रांड्स में इंटरेस्ट है आप डेफिनेटली टाइप के लोगों को टारगेट कर सकते हो. एडसेट लेवल पे जब आप फेसबुक पे जाते हो वहां पे होता है डिटेल टारगेटिंग बिहेवियर का. तो आप वहां पे आप जाके पीपल इंटरेस्टेड इन जोडियक शर्ट्स, पीपल इंटरेस्टेड इन कोई और कंपेटिटर ब्रांड है तो उसका नाम डाल दो. आप जो आपके आप अपने 10 कंपेटिटर्स के नाम लिस्ट डाउन कर लो और आप उसको एडसेट लेवल पे मेंशन कर सकते हो एंड देन यू कैन टारगेट दोस पीपल विथ योर ब्रांड.
ओके ओके, आप एक बार फिर से रिपीट करेंगे जो आपने एडसेट में जो मुझे सर्च करना है वो लिखना है. वो
डिटेल टारगेटिंग बिहेवियर होता है एडसेट लेवल पे फेसबुक पे.
डिटेल टारगेटिंग बिहेवियर,
हाँ जी हाँ जी. आप मेरे को अपना ईमेल आईडी दे दीजिए, आई कैन गेट यू कनेक्टेड ऑफलाइन एंड देन मैं आपको समझा सकता हूँ ये.
ओके ओके, किस में चैट बॉक्स में ही दे देती हूँ.
मैंने डाला हुआ है, मैं आपको फिर से मैसेज कर देता हूँ अपना ईमेल आईडी.
ओके ओके ओके, थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू थैंक यू.
Thank you, Parul. Giving an opportunity to Ragit. Please go and ask your question, Ragit.
Kapil ji, इधर एक suggestion था कि like अभी इंडिया में सारे e-commerce website address use करते. अब कोई उसको लिखता है street number one, कोई लिखता है गली number one, वो landmark use करते. अब जैसे Google satellites पर आपने देखा होगा या फिर Map My India करके एक website है, वहाँ पे पूरा satellite view से house number तक mark हो जाता है. तब अपन एड्रेस फीड करता है कोई भी कस्टमर, जैसे अमेज़न की वेबसाइट पर कोई भी कस्टमर एड्रेस सेव कर रहा है तो उसको लोकेशन नहीं मार्क करके मार्क कर सकता वो गूगल सैटेलाइट के थ्रू या मैप माइंड के थ्रू अपना एकदम एग्जैक्ट हाउस नंबर, तो डिलीवरी बॉय को इजी रहेगा डिलीवरी के टाइम. ऐसा कुछ पॉसिबल है?
तो दैट्स अ ग्रेट सजेशन. ये तो सर सजेशन पहुंचाना पड़ेगा एंड डेफिनेटली हमारा जितने भी अटेंडीज स्पीकर्स हैं डेफिनेटली वो एक उनके लिए एक अच्छा सजेशन है. Which I am sure they will be looking forward to implement it. Maybe some technical challenges.
I just take this quickly. Ragit, आपका suggestion बिल्कुल valid है, लेकिन Google आप Map My India में भी देख सकते हो. Actually हम Third Watch में दोनों use करते हैं, Google Maps as well as Google Map My India. दिक्कत इसमें ये आता है कि काफी locations ऐसे हैं, especially tier 2, tier 3 में, जहाँ जो गूगल लोकेशन है वो एक्चुअल लोकेशन से थोड़ा सा दूर होता है. उस वजह से क्या होता है कि आपका एग्जैक्ट जो हाउस नंबर है वो चेंज हो जाता है. ये एक्चुअली मैं पर्सनली भी एक्सपीरियंस किया, ये बैंगलोर में भी होता है, दिल्ली में भी होता है. मान लो कि आपने लाइक यू नो फ्लोर डिफरेंट है आपका या आप अपार्टमेंट में रहते हो, तो ऐसे काफी चैलेंजेस है. तो हमने थर्ड वॉच में ये काफी इम्प्लीमेंट करने के लिए कोशिश तो किया था, बट ऐसे चैलेंजेस हमको बहुत मिल रहे हैं. I hope that answers your question, Ravi.
Thank you, Vijay. So now let me, Ashwin, I'm giving you, I'm opening you to, you know, ask question. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me, sir? Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, yeah.
Sir, actually, we are having our presence in marketplaces like Amazon and Flipkart, and we are doing quite good in those places. But I'm having very specific problem with the RTO thing. When they give back us the products, we don't get what we have sent to the customers. They will put some other item inside and they'll give back to us. Or the quantity, if you had sent 10 numbers, they would have given only 2 or 3 numbers back. They would have used, and some places they have used the item and they have bent or like, you know, it is broken or something and it has come back. When we are approaching the marketplaces there, sometimes we get the money back, a little amount, and sometimes they don't give it back. So it's a big loss for us. How to control this particular RTO, these type of RTOs?
Sure. Two aspects to it. One just quick question. Are you managing it through some software? Are you managing your entire operations through some software, or it is you are managing it manually?
No, sir. It is actually through Amazon. We are doing the dashboard thing, and for courier thing, we are using. It is a ship rocket, sir.
So, are you just selling? Are you just only selling on Amazon?
Amazon and Flipkart also.
Okay. So somebody from the logistics space can pick this up, and then later, the second part, I can really help you out how to get it resolved.
Okay. Okay.
Hi Ashwin, this is a very relevant question. We've seen this come up very frequently nowadays. So there are two parts to it. One is wherein there is a packaging error, and second, when the shipment has actually been, when there is an actual theft case. So packaging error, I suggest it can be resolved by, so we've seen a lot of times that shipping labels don't have the entire description. So let's say you're shipping out 2 pieces or 10 pieces, but the SKU or the shipping partner is not printing all the pieces on the label. So your packaging resource, the person who's packaging the shipments in your warehouse might have only packed one product or one quantity or lesser quantity.
Okay.
So is that. Second is the obvious reason that ripped out 5 products, but the but somewhere in its journey, in its transit journey, the it was tampered with and some part of it was stolen. So for this, I suggest that you always do a reconciliation for all of the RTOs that are being received at time of RTO delivery only, and not at a later stage.
Okay.
Because if you do at a later stage, you will not be able to mark it as RTO. You know, you'll not be able to mark the proof of delivery. You'll need to mark the carrier delivery boy's proof of delivery that there is a tamper on the packaging, that their shipment is short. It might take 10 minutes more. It might take at least 5 minutes more. But, you know, this helps you understand if there was a packaging error or a transit issue.
Okay. How to do with the shipment people, sir? Like, you know, for example, if I get back RTO from a courier company like Blue Dart, how when they come to give back the RTO thing, the item, how to stop them before taking the item to our handover, sir?
So, Ashwin, whenever any delivery boy comes back with your RTO shipments, they will always ask you to ask your team to stamp the POD or sign the POD.
Correct, correct.
And what is the volume that you do on a daily basis?
Approximately 15 to 20 packages per day, sir.
So RTO
is around 3 to 4. We deliver, I mean, we send almost 20 packages per day.
If you are shipping out 20 packages a day from Amazon through ShipRocket, that means that Amazon self-ship.
No, no, both. Right. Amazon may be are doing more than 40-50 per day.
Okay, right. Yes. So, when they come back with 3 to 4 packages a day, you need to make a process at your warehouse to check package for tampering and then accordingly mention the remarks in the proof of delivery.
Okay, okay, okay. Okay.
Also, one more suggestion from my side, like couriers are also provide packaging facility. So in that case, it is totally courier responsibility to count the items before pack and when pick up from the customer. So, but courier is not providing the packaging facility on all of the pin codes, but courier is providing around 60% on 60% pin codes. You can avail that facility, courier packaging facility also. In that case, like the item loss thing will be reduced by your customer end.
Okay, sir. Okay, okay.
Thank you, Ashwin ji. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Unicommerce, for giving an opportunity to talk. Thank you.
Definitely, definitely. So, Ashwin ji, I would also request you to write back to contact us at unicommerce.com. We can help you get a better solution to it, because all these problems will occur if you are managing everything on Excel. And there's a tool, mechanism to do it, with which will give you 100% foolproof solution to it. Not only this, I would just also recommend you to check your payment reconciliation, which you'll find some glitches there. You'll find some lacuna loopholes there also, in which you may be also losing a lot in terms of your payment reconciliation part. So just write it to Unicommerce, contact us at unicommerce.com. We'll help you out with everything.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I'll do it now itself.
So now, and
Ashwin, I've put down the mail ID of contactus@unicommerce.com in the chat box. You can check for there as well.
So now I'm giving this right to Hamza. Hamza, please ask your question.
Sir, most of the time, actually, in my experience, there are a lot of incidents.
Hamza, are you able to hear you? And kindly unmute yourself, Hamza. earlier you were unmute, but your voice was a bit husky. So
can you hear me?
Yeah, it is better.
Okay. Yeah, I have a question which is relevant to this delivery issues. When the material is delivered to the customer, customers don't have the opportunity to open it and check it before the delivery boy leaves. Is there any solution for this one?
Sorry, Hamza, we are not able to hear you.
I'm asking a question regarding the delivery. When the delivery, when the material is delivered to the customer,
sorry, Hamza, unable to hear you. So let me just give this opportunity to Ujjwala. Ujjwala, please ask your question.
Yeah, hi. Can you hear me?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. So my question was regarding fragile items. And like, you know, many times like we sell on Flipkart and Amazon. So we pack it very well, but when it comes back as a return, okay, and our wall, so we ship wall clocks, so sometimes it gets broken. So, like, can any courier partner, like, you know, provide any guarantee while returning the product? Like, you know, because, you know, while returning, I mean, they don't use the same packing materials, they just pack it anyhow and give it back.
Sure. Thank you for sharing your question. I'm sure Parina would love to answer this.
Yes, yes. So, Ujjwala, I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly. From the chat, I thought your question is about forward packaging. But from what I understand, it is for reverse orders. Shipments which have been first delivered, but due to whatever issues, customer wants to ship it back. I hope that is correct. So unfortunately, there is no carrier which will pack it the way a shipper packs the shipment in while dispatching it forward. So it's best to, you know, minimize your reverse queries. If it's from Amazon, you need to speak with your probably your Amazon account manager that when in case of reverse orders, we get a lot of damages and the shipping is not proper, because no carrier will use proper bubble wrap or a proper corrugated box. They just put in tamper proof and bring it back to you while picking it up from the consignee. This is a industry level problem and there is no solution to it yet.